guys, do you mention vibrations? I do. This is Vojtech Vibration again, and today we got a routine measurement. Last time I showed you my data, routine data, what do I measure every time. So this is it. So let's check it, and after that I will show you something, how do I analyze something from trend analysis and also from frequency analysis, especially usage of cursors and so on. So let's go. Again, and welcome in DDS. I have measured data during my route, and now I want to go through it and show you my analysis procedure on one measurement point with bearing fault on an industrial fan. First, I take a look on a velocity spectrum. I prefer graph type spectrum plus trend because it gives me better overview. Velocity is only one quantity when you can respect a standard. But I take a standard only as a part of data analysis. A trend contains overall RMS values counted from the spectrum. In a trend, it's important to check if it increases. If yes, and rapidly, you have to find out in a spectrum why is that happening. The trend here looks constant. RMS value is low and there are no significant frequencies in the spectrum. So let's move on demodulation. In the second step in demodulation spectrum, you should always try to find beginning fault frequencies and their harmonics. It's very useful to turn on a harmonic cursor. Turning on of harmonic cursor is provided by left click on a mouse in the spectrum. Then just moved by the cursor on the frequency you think is a fault frequency. Now you can see that you move only in frequency step, which is defined by number of lines and measured range. If I want more specific value, I should turn on locate peak to get most real value. I can turn it by right click and find locate peak. Guys, I'm too lazy to do that all the time with so many spectrums. Therefore, I truly recommend to set up this function as a shortcut. So go into tools, shortcuts, and in the part graph, find locate peak. I set it up as a letter P on your keyboard. So I located peak on the frequency 74.9 Hz with harmonics. By the way, below the spectrum is a trend. Now it trends the values on the specific frequency 74.9 Hz. If it is controlled machine, you should not pay any attention and turn off the cursor to see overall RMS trend. But back to our analysis. Now I'm interested in this frequency, but how can I recognize it? First step is that I input the speed to the measurement point to see the orders. I guess you don't usually measure the speed. Sometimes you can find the speed in the velocity spectrum as a dominant peak. You should also know where you should expect the dominant frequency according to number of poles of the motor or supplying frequency from variable frequency drive. I know that in this case our motor from a fan has 8 poles, so nominal speed is 737 rpm. Motor is also controlled by frequency drive. I move my cursor on a speed frequency, and I think it is also second harmonic in this case. Now, let's move to a graph part, and I select set speed. You can see that it automatically takes speed from the cursor. Then, select it for a measurement point. It means I will have the speed in the each measurement in this point. And then also select the last values. It means that you get the speed for the last measurement. Now, when I look again on demodulation spectrum, again on the frequency with harmonic cursor, I see the order of the speed. Most of the faults or failures depend on speed of rotary machines. Usually, bearing fault frequency's constant is not integer multiple. Let's take a look into a bearings database in tools and bearings. You can see here constants for the outer ring, for the inner ring, frequencies and so on. Usually, they are not integer multiple, so this is easy way how to recognize a bearing fault. For sure, it is always better to input bearing type if you have it, and then check it. I add a bearing type in properties into the bearings. After I set up a speed, I can display bearing frequencies labels. I can turn it on by right-click in the spectrum and select labels and display bearing. Well, again, I think that this function deserves a shortcut and you can be more effective with the shortcut. So try to set it. Maybe you are asking if the bearing should be changed. I will tell you that in the next video, where I will talk about sideband cursor and analysis in acceleration spectrums. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video about harmonic cursor, shortcuts and trend analysis. Thank you for watching and see you next time.